Broadcasting out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, you're listening to the Low Blow MMA Boxing Podcast.
Jorge Hernandez with the Low Blow and Southwest Fight News here with UFC fighter out of Jackson's MMA, Leonard Garcia. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. How are you guys?
Pretty good. Good to see you back in action. You were going at it just now.
It was good, man. You know, good, tough training sessions. I got, you know, great training partners. You know, me and Go are fighting on the same card, so we really like pushing each other. Yeah. It's fun.
Now it's been a good 6-7 months since your last fight. You unfortunately injured yourself, you injured your foot, and you were in a pretty good contest, and you've been in some wars, man. How does it feel to, I guess, do you feel 100%?
Yeah, it feels good to go into a fight healthy. You know, in my last fight, I walked in there, I had a fractured ankle, or right above the ankle. You know, that's a scary feeling, man. You know, you're fighting the best people in the world. You know, the UFC, the caliber of guys that are there, there's no easy fights, man. So if you're fighting somebody, they're an expert at something, you know. So going into a fight like that injured, you know, they say a wounded animal is the most dangerous. That's not the case in the UFC. You know, if you're wounded, man, you're at a disadvantage. And you know, it showed. I had a great fight. You know, I felt like I showed heart. I'm getting tired of showing my heart, man. I'm ready to show my skills. So yeah, this fight, I'm excited.
Now you're at UFC 155. You're fighting McKenzie there. The card is pretty loaded. And I mean, you're with Goyo here.
It's stacked, man. You know, the fact that I'm fighting with Goyo and Cain Velasquez on the same card is, I mean, that's like a dream come true. You know, when Goyo first got here, I always told him, man, you know, we're going to be on a card someday, me and you. And, you know, to have Cain as the main event, you know, it's big for both of us. So I'm excited, man. And, you know, McKenzie, I hope you're training hard, man, because I'm in here killing it.
Now, it's the last card of the year. Did you want to come back this year, or were you thinking of next year, or was this just the best opportunity for you?
You know, I, coming off an injury, you're always wanting to come back as soon as you can. It's something that drives you. You feel like you got to get back in there. You got to prove something. To be able to get in there before the year ends and start a new year, you know, in good graces, you know, I mean, God willing, you know, I'm going to win this fight and go on a tear next year. So, you know, this is the first step to it.
Yeah, now you're coming off 3 consecutive losses. I mean, is this live or die here with this fight, do you think? Or?
Definitely. The 3 losses were an eye-opener for me. Of course, you know, the last fight, I did go in injured and had to fight for financial reasons, stuff like that. But, you know, even training for that fight, you know, I felt like I was a superstar. You know, I felt like I got the everything they say about me is true. I got the superstar syndrome, it's called. And you see it in a lot of guys. Nobody really likes to admit it, but you know, I had to swallow my pride and realize that I wasn't as good as I thought I was. You know, I live and train with Donald Cerrone. Did the same training regimens as him. The difference is, he's a better athlete than I was, you know, and I'm smarter than he is, but his athleticism, it carries over. So he's like a freak, man. You teach a guy something, 5 minutes later, he's using it against you. I'm not that way. I have to see something 100 times to make it work. So, I mean, here we are Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon, and I'm here in the gym. Where's Cowboy at? He's probably skiing somewhere, you know. Come Monday morning, we'll be at the same skill set because, you know, that's just the way it is. But it took me to swallow my pride in these 3 losses to realize that. And sometimes, man, you know, especially fighters, man, we need to get slapped every now and again with the little reality. And that's what it took, man. And you know, I'm hoping that all this hard work pays off. But I mean, everybody knows, you know, hard work does pay off. And when I first got to Jackson's, you know, 5.5 years ago, that's all I knew was hard work. And you know, I started believing, started seeing interviews, started seeing my picture here, started seeing, you know, people talking about me here and there. And I don't know what got into me, man, but I'm glad it got out.
So what was it that actually humbled you? Was it the 3 consecutive victories and the injury, or do you think it was the injury the most?
You know, I walked into that fight with an injury, but I wasn't in the best shape. And the thing that I watched the fight, and when I seen the fight, there was a lot of opportunities I had to win. A lot of things that I seen in the fight that I seen during the fight and didn't capitalize on. And after I left there, you know, you leave and you got time to think. You know, I was sitting there, had the thing on my foot, couldn't really train. And I started to think, man, like what was the difference back then and now? And it took a lot of thought, and you know, I had to humble myself, I'm a Christian, man. I always have been, and you know, I let go of that, and I went back to it, and I think that's actually gonna help me a lot, man. Because I mean, everybody knows, man. If God's behind you, you're gonna do it, you know. Yeah. So it made a huge difference now, and you know, I'm excited for it. So
would you say it was your faith and also your team here that helped you out?
Definitely, my team here is the biggest attribute that we have. You know, like there's no easy rounds in this gym. Mm-hmm. No easy rounds. Even the up and coming guys. You know, we got a kid, Hunter Tucker. You know, I mean, a few years back, I mean, I didn't even want to go to the kid because he had no skills. You know, I was like, you know, whatever. Easy round. Now he's taking my head off. You know what I mean? And every round is that way. So, you know, I'm blessed to have this team, man. And if you can't take advantage of that, like I wasn't before, you know, I was stupid for not taking advantage. Now I'm taking full advantage of it, so I'm ready.
Yeah, and finally, a message to any of your fans who have been waiting for your return, man.
And everybody, you know, like I said, man, God willing, this next year, man, I'm gonna make my true fans real fans, and you know, even the guys who before used to say, oh man, Leonard's not that good, you know, he's kind of a brawler, he's crazy, you know, those guys are gonna become fans too. So I'm excited to show you guys what I got in store, and Cody McKenzie, I'm coming for you. UFC 155, you're in trouble, buddy.
Well, best of luck. It's good to finally have you back, and good to finally see you back on the scene. And, you know, people have loved you just based on the fact that you come to entertain. So it's great to have you back.
Thank you, buddy.
UFC 155. We'll catch you guys.